Dear students, today we are going to teach about representation of the decimals on the number line. Today our class is third day. On third day I am going to teach you about how to represent a decimal on the number line. How to represent decimals on the number line. Now I take a decimal as 4.862. Now I am going to represent this decimal on the number line. See children, 4.862, that means this decimal lies between 4 and 5. This decimal lies between 4 and 5. If you observe on the scale, centimeters from 4 to 5, I divide that 1 centimeter into 10 equal parts. 1 centimeter from 4 to 5 I divided into 10 equal parts. That means in the scale every part is equal to 1 mm, so that every part representing the decimal as 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, 4.5, 4.6, 4.7, 4.8, 4.9, then the number is 5. Next children, here the after point the decimal is number 1, 8. First decimal is 8. So we divide again from 4.8 to next decimal 4.9. I divide this 1 mm, that means 1 millimeter, divide into again 10 equal parts. This is the one type of magnification. Magnification of 4.862 we are doing here. Magnify means if we see in lenses, magnification lenses, and that means that type of extending the process. So I divide 4.8 into again 10 parts, then 4.8 to 4.9, this part dividing into 10 parts, then first part equal to 4.81, this is 4.80, 4.81, 4.82, 4.83, 4.84, 4.85, 4.86, 4.87, 4.88, 4.89, then 4.90. This is nothing but numbering. 81, 82, 89, 90. Again after 86, then third decimal is 2. So again we are going to divide 4.86, then next decimal is 4.87. Again I am going to dividing this part into 10 parts. Then the first part equal to 4.860. The next decimal is 4.81, 862, 863, 4.864, 4.865, 4.876, 4.867, 4.868, 4.869, 4.870. So the given decimal is here 4.862. Where it is? Here. This is the required decimal representing on the number line. This is the required decimal representing on the decimal. Okay students? Students, next I take another decimal which is non-terminating recurring decimal. In the previous example, I take a terminating decimal. Now I take non-terminating recurring decimal. How to represent this non-terminating recurring decimal on the number line? So given now the non-terminating decimal, observe this. Given non-terminating decimal is 3.58 bar. So we take what numbers? 3. Next number is 4. So on the scale, the centimeter from 3 to 4, which are I divide into 10 equal parts. On the scale, every part equal to, you know that every part equal to 1 mm. So first part equal to 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4, 3.5, 3.6, 3.7, 3.8, 3.9, then number is, next number is 4. So from 3 to 4 I divided the this into 10 equal parts. Next students, observe this given decimal number 3.5888. 8 bar means 5888, so on. I take up to 3 digits. To 3 digits only. So 3.5 here. We have to take next decimal means 3.6. So I divided the 3.5 to 3.6 into 10 equal parts, which are equal to 3.50, the next number is 3.51, next number is 52, 53, 54, 55, 57, 59, then 560, 59th of the time 60, next 3.60. So 3.5 to 3.6 I divided into 10 equal parts, and given that each part will the decimal form as like this. Then third decimal is here 3.588. So we divide 3.58, next number is 3.59. This part I divided into again 10 equal parts. I divided 3.58 to 3.59. This part to again I divide into 10 equal parts. Then the let the first given decimal as 3.580. We can write 58 equal to 580. Therefore 3.580. The next first two part is 3.581, 582, 3.583, 3.584, 3.585, 3.586, 3.587, 3.588, 3.589, then the given number 3.590. So given decimal where it is 3.588, here it is. This is the required decimal and representing the this decimal on the number line. Okay students, this is the required decimal continuing on the number line. Okay students, next I am going to tell you about the square roots of the numbers. The square root of number 2, the square root of 3, the square root of 4, the square root of 5, the square root of 6, so on. Do you know square root of 2? We don't know. Do you know square root of 4? No. Do you know square root of 4? Yes. Square root of 4 is equal to 2. We can write the square root of 4 is equal to 2. Next, square root of 5? We cannot. We don't know. square root of 6, you don't know. So on, if you write down the square root of 9, yes, the square root of 9 is equal to 3. In these numbers, square root numbers, some numbers we cannot find their square roots. Some has the square roots. Some of the numbers has square roots. So, which numbers we cannot find the square roots, those numbers are called irrational. Those numbers are called irrational. How to find that square root? Now, I am telling you how to find the square root of. Of course, we cannot find exact square root, but up to 3 decimals, 4 decimals, 5 decimals, we can find. So on. So now, I am finding the square root of 2. Find the square root of 2 up to 3 decimals. Up to 3 decimals. How to find the square root of 2 up to 3 decimals? Now, I tell you the process how to find this square root, which is a irrational number. We cannot find that square root exact value. This type of square roots, we can find these by this process. Draw these two lines vertically. Which number we have to find? 2. So, put here 2. Then, put a decimal. Since we have to find up to 3 decimals, we take here 3 pairs of zeros. 1, 2, 3. We take 3 pairs of zeros. This is the process to find the square root of a irrational number, which I take here as 2. If you multiply a number by the same number, which comes up to 2, we have to take that number. 1 into 1, 1. If we take 2 into 2, 4, which is not possible here. So, I take 1 into 1. Write here 1 and 1 is here. So 1 into 1, 1. Then subtract. 2 minus 1, 1. Now put down this pair like here, which is equal to 100. Now right here, double this right, which right here, 1 is, then double the number. As 2. 1 plus 1, 2. If the number is 2, 2 plus 2, 4 right here. So 1 plus 1, and that means double this number, 2. After 2, here whatever we write here a number, we multiply the same number. Observe this, students. If you write, for example, I take given number is 2. After 2, if you write 4, multiply the same number, 4. If you write 3, multiply by 3, same. This is the process finding this square root. So, if you write 4, 4, 4 is 16, 4, 2 is 8, 8 plus 1, 9, which is possible here. If you take 2, 5, then multiply by 5, 25 into 5, which is equal to 125, not possible here. This is smaller than that number. So, we take 4 as number here, then which is decimal, so put a decimal here, write the number same, 1.4. Then multiply the 4 by 24, 4 into 24. Multiplied here 96. Then subtracting again 100 minus 96. How much? 4. again put down that pair 2 zeros here. Same process. Here we write, we already write down 2, so which number we put here? 4. So double this number, 8. Now this number will be 280. How much number we have to write here? That means if you write 282 multiply by same number 2, then multiplication is 2 2 is 4, 2 8 is 16, 2 2 is 4, 4 plus 1 5, which is not possible here because this number is greater than this 400. So we have to write here the number 1. 281. The same number right here. 1 into 281. Then again subtract. 10 minus 1, 9. 9 minus 1, 8. 119. Again, write put here, write down, put down the 2 zeros again here. What number we have to write here? Already 2, 8. Here the whatever the number write down here 1. Then double this number as 2. 1 plus 1 2. This number will be 2000s. We have to write a number here. Then this number multiplied by the same number. This students. 2000, whatever number here, 282, but we have a number write down here. Which number is possible here? We have to observe by multiplication. 2820, write 5, multiply by 5. Come on, multiply. 5 into 5, 25. 5 2 is 10, 10 plus 2, 12. 5 8 is 40, 41, 41. 5 2 is 10, 10 plus 4, 14. Which we get 14,125, which is not possible here. So we multiply, we have to write as less than 5. If you write 2824, to write my 5 is not possible here. That number is greater than 11,900. So right, we multiply this 4 4 4 16, 4 2 is 8 plus 1 9, 4 8 is 32, 4 2 is 8 plus 3 11. We get this is enough to write here, and which is our required number. So 282, which is equal to now 2800, we have to write down here 4. The same number right here. 2824 into 4. What number will we find here? 296. And subtract. 4 0 6. This is the remainder. Students, observe this process, and you have to find some more numbers which are root 3, root 5, root 7, root 8. You can find any number, take any number. You can find 3 decimals up to 3. If we ask for 5 decimals, we have right 5 pairs of zeros. So now we are going to find the up to 3 decimals. So I put 3 pairs of zeros here. 1 into 1, 1. Again subtracting 100, we get 100. Next, the number to we write as 4. 4 into 4, 96. Sorry, 4 into 24, 96. Then subtracting 4 and write down here 2 pairs of 0, 2 zeros. Then it will be 400. We double the number 4 as 8. Now the number you have right here is 1. 1 into 281. Next, by subtracting, we get the answer as 119. Again, step down the two zeros here, then it will be 11,900. This number will be 2,824. This multiply this is 4 by 4, we get the answer 11,286. This is the required answer. Okay, children? Okay, students, now I am taking another irrational number, which is 5. Now I am going to find the square root of 5 up to 3 decimals. So we have to find the square root of 5. So we put 5 is here, then put the decimal. Since we have to find up to 3 decimals, we write down here 3 pairs of zeros. Students, now the first question is, by which number we have to multiply the same number? If you take 2, multiply by 2. If you take 3, multiply the same number, 3. 3 is a 9. Up to 5, which number we have to multiply the same number? 2. 2 into 2, 4, which is enough here. If you take 3, 3 into 3, 9, which is greater than the 5. So that number not equal to, does not possible here. So we take 2 and the same number right here and put decimal here. Is after decimal all zeros, so we put decimal here. 2 into 2, same process, 4. Next, 5 minus 4, 1, and write down the pair 2 zeros, and it will be 100. Now what we have to do? Double this number, 2 plus 2, 4, double. 2 plus 2, 4. Now the question is, what number we have to write here? If you write 2, multiply the 2 by 42. If you write 3, multiply the 3 by 43. So, which is possible here? Here, we have to practice on the rough side of the page. If you take 43, multiply by 3, which is equal to 9, 129, which is greater than the 100. So this is not possible. So we have to take 42 into 2, which is equal to 84. So we write down here 2, the same number right here, 2. 2 into 42, how much? 84. Then subtracting, we get the answer is here, 16. Then take another pair of zeros, 2 zeros. Then what number we have to write here? We already write 4. The number we write here is 2. So double this number, again 4. Then it will be 400. What number we have to write here? Up to get to this number is 1600. So write down 440. How much? If you take 3, multiply by 3. If you take 4, multiply by 4. If you take 4, 4 is 16. This will be greater than the 1600. So we have to take 3. By observation, I got the answer is 3 is 9, 4 is 12, 3 4 is 12, and 13. 1329. So, right, 3. Same number right here, 3. 3 into 443 equal to 1329. And subtracting 1, 9 minus 2, 7, 5 minus 3, 2, 270. Now write down the last pair of zeros, 2 zeros. What we have to do here? 44 already, there, the number, the right rear is 3, so we have to double the number 3 plus 3, 6. Now this will be 4000. So what we have to do here is, if you multiply 4,046, 4,027 means 58 5 multiply by 5 5 5 is 25 5 6 is 30 plus 2 32 5 4 is 20 20 plus 3 23 5 4 is 20 20 plus 3 23. Again students, 5 5 is 25, 5 is 30, 30 plus 3, 33, 5 5 is 25, 5 6 is 30, 30 plus 2, 32, 5 4 is 20, 20 plus 3, 23, 5 4 is 20, 22. No, 20 plus 2 22 22,325. By subtracting 5 9 minus 2 7 10 minus 3 7, here it is 6 6 minus 2 4. This is the remainder. Number we have here 5. Here it is 5. So square root of 5 is equal to how much? 2.235, which is the required square root of 5. Okay students, you have to take some more exams and practice the same manner to get the required square root of any irrational number. Okay students, now let us know about the, which we already discussed about the irrational numbers. What is the difference between us? Once again we know about this difference, rational, irrational. You must observe this and find out, you have to find the difference between the rational and irrational. Rational means even. Irrational is nothing but the numbers which we cannot write in the form of P by Q. We cannot write in the form of P by Q. We already find some irrational numbers. For example, if you take square root of 2, we already find what the square root is, 1.414 or something, it will come, so on, there is no end. We find here up to 3 decimals. But if you going on this process, the previous square root, finding the square roots, you can find the this will come, so on, so which is there no end, therefore that means this kind of decimals are called non-terminating non-recurring decimals. Non-terminating, which are not terminate, and non-recurring, any digits are not repeating. So this type of numbers are called irrational numbers, which we cannot write in the form of P by Q. If you write P by Q, these may be non-terminating recurring decimal, there may be terminating decimal. So which we cannot write in the form of P by Q, those numbers are called non-terminating, non-recurring, which we define it as irrational numbers. Okay, students, I write here some more examples to understand and to differentiate the rational or irrational. You have to find which is rational and which is irrational. So I write first example as root 4. Do you know about the square root of 4? Easily 2. 2 into 2, 4. Therefore, square root of 4 is equal to 2. Another example. Observe this. 3 into root 18. We have to simplify this to find this is rational or irrational. So, write 3 into root. We have to factorize the 18 as 9 into 2 because the square root of 9 is 3. So, to write the factors of 18 as 9 into 2, we no need of 6 into 3. 3 into the square root of 9 is 3. So write 3 here. We don't know the square root of 2. We put 2 as root 2. This will be 9 root 2. Since it is not a rational, therefore this is a irrational. Since it is a root 2, so therefore root 2 into something which is equal to irrational. Here this is rational. Rational. Again, students, I gave here another example. Square root of 1.44. Square root of 1.44. How much you already know that square root of 144? Which is equal to 12. So yeah, we write down here 1.2 into 1.2, which is equal to 1.44. Therefore, the square root of 1.44 is equal to 1.2, which is a terminating decimal. We can write this as a PVQ form. This is a rational. This is a rational. Next, students, square root of 9/27. Separate the square root into numerator into denominator. Separate this square root. Square root of 9 is 3. Again, factorize the 27 into 9 into 10. Because we have square root of 9 is equal to 3. Therefore, 3 by 3 into root 3. 3, 3 cancel, which is equal to root 3. Since it is a root 3, so it is a irrational. This it is irrational. Next example, observe the students. Square root of 100. 10 into 10. 10 into 10. Therefore, it is 10. Here I gave another example. Root 5 plus 1. Students, tell this. This is rational or irrational? Rational. Rational. So, I gave another example. Root 5 plus 1 into root 5 minus 1. Which is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. If you have observed this example, you have to recall the algebraic formula, which is a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a plus b means a square minus b square. Here root 5 is a, 1 is b. Therefore, this is equal to a square root 5 whole square minus b square 1 square. Root 5 whole square means square root and square cancel, which is equal to 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. And it is rational. It is rational. Next, another example. Observe this another example. I take a decimal. Observe this example. 0.70. Next, after 7, 2 zeros. Next, after 7, 3 zeros. Next, after 7, 4 zeros. Next will be 5 zeros. So on. Which are not terminating and non-terminating and non-recurring. Therefore, this number is a, this decimal is a non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. Therefore, what we call this as? Irrational. This is irrational. So, students, you can easily understand the definition of rational and irrational. Rational plus irrational, those two types or whole family is called real number, which is our first chapter, real number chapter, or chapter is real numbers. So real numbers means the big family, which is rational plus irrational. The sum of all those numbers are called real numbers. This is our chapter name. Okay students, today you learn two concepts, which is first one is magnifying the decimal and second one is finding the square root of irrational number. Those two concepts you learn today. On these two concepts I give you worksheets, exercise number 1.2 in your textbook page number 14. There are the problems 1, 2, 5, 6. These four problems are on the concept of which we learned on the irrational and finding the square root, those models. Next, in the exercise 1.3, page number 17 in your textbook, do problem number 1 and 2. These two problems are magnifying the decimal model. So, practice these problems to understand more. Okay, students, tomorrow we will discuss about some more concepts on real numbers.